Where would I be? God only knows. I'm glad you see through eyes of love. Oh, I was a hopeless kid, an empty space. Oh, if not for grace. God only knows. I'm glad you see through eyes of love. I was a hopeless kid, an empty space. Oh, if not for grace. Amazing grace.
But now I'm found, a hopeless case, an empty space. If not grace, where would I be? Where would I be? God only knows. I'm glad you see through eyes of love, a hopeless case, an empty space. If not for grace, oh, it's His amazing grace. Oh, amazing grace, how sweet the sound. I once was lost, but now I'm found, a hopeless case, an empty space, if not for grace. Praise God. Praise God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Where would we be? Divine love projects, sovereign grace takes over. Thank God for the grace of God in our lives. We could never stop thanking Him enough and praising Him enough. Are you happy? I know you're happy to be here tonight. What a beautiful anointing. What a beautiful anointing tonight. We're getting ready to introduce our speaker. You may be seated just a couple of moments before we bring our speaker up tonight, but I just want to go back to this morning to Brother Nanton and just say how much we appreciate you, Brother Nanton, for redeemed by the manifestation of the name of God on the third phase. Wasn't that something? You know, He took us on a journey to see how the predestinated seeds of God, who are a virgin of His word, how they come forth. And it was such a graphic journey that you took us on, Brother Nanton, and how that the true seed bride was hidden throughout the church ages. And how would they come forth? But He said how God interprets His own word by bringing it to pass. And the manifestation, He said, of the Holy Spirit is that angel, and His name is in that angel. And we saw how it was interpreted, what? The word for seven church ages. Seven times in seven church ages, God manifesting His name throughout those church ages. Brother Nanton, what a beautiful, beautiful message. What a beautiful message. He Himself interprets and manifests How is it going to be? How will I come to perfection? How will I come to adoption? Don't worry about it. You have a seed planted inside of you, and it shall come to perfection. How is it going to come, Lord? I interpret my own word, and I manifest it for the world to see. How are you going to rebuild me, Lord? I'll take charity disguised as virtue power, and I'll form you into my word image. And when you are totally formed into my word image, then I will send down and I will interpret my own word. It will speak for itself. It won't be you. It'll be me in you. Say, come. The Spirit and the Bride say, come. Thank you, Brother Nansen. We could never be the same again. What a beautiful, beautiful message. And tonight, we have with us from West Africa, Sierra Leone, Brother John Conte. Amen. And as when we introduced Brother Ben Achute, we recalled how the inspiration on December 28th that the Lord gave Brother Coleman, that both Brother Ben Achute and Brother Conte were indeed a sign that the voice angel of Revelation 10:8-11 had moved over to Ephesians 4:11. What was it? A sign of the fivefold ministry. And this meeting is dedicated to a salute to the fivefold ministry. And last night we heard from East Africa. And will we bless from East Africa? So are you ready for West Africa tonight? Amen. And the devil fought our brother, but the Lord opened up embassies. We did everything, but God did it. And we got our brother here. They said no, God said yes. They said no visa, God said give him a year visa. Amen. When God wants his man somewhere, he'll make a way. And we'll reach a season soon when he'll translate him here anyway. Amen. And how can we forget his message in Ghana? Sons of God coming back to Ephesians. So are you ready? Father, let the fire fall. Father, let the fire fall. Amen. Let us greet our brother Johnny Conte from Sierra Leone. Oh, Father, let the fire fall. Oh, Father, let the fire fall. Hey, let the fire fall. Let the fire fall. Let the Pentecostal fire. Everybody, Father, let the fire fall. Well, Father, let the fire. Well, let the fire fall, let the fire fall, let the Pentecostal fire. Everybody, Father, let the fire fall. Well, now, Father, let the fire fall. Oh, let the fire fall, let the fire fall, let the Pentecostal fire. Sing it again now, Father, let the fire fall. Well, Father, let the fire fall. Just let the fire fall, let the fire fall, let the Pentecost. Come on, let's clap. Think he's gonna finish tonight? I don't think so. Fire's already here. Anything could happen. Everybody, Father, let the fire fall. Let the fire fall. Anything you need tonight, he's here. Let the fire fall. Let the fire fall. Let the pen you got. Let me hear you.
Fire fall, glory, let the Pentecostal fire, glory, Father, let the, oh, let the fire, fire, oh, yes, let the fire, hallelujah, Pentecostal fire, one more time, glory, yeah, Father, let the fire, hallelujah, open. Oh, it's nice. It feels nice. It feels good. One more time. One more time. Glory, Father, let the fire. Just turn around and bless your brother. Say, God bless you. It's fire falling time. Oh, when the fire fall, fire fall, the Pentecost. Cause the fire fall, oh, let the fire. Let the fire fall, the Pentecostal fire fall. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, thank you, Jesus. Raise up your hands and thank him and praise him. Hallelujah, glory to God. Amen. Lord, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. May the fire fall tonight. Oh, those without the Holy Ghost, may God baptize you with the Holy Ghost tonight. Amen. May God send down power tonight. Amen. To help you grow in this Christian journey. God bless you. You may be seated for a while. And we are happy tonight. It's good being in Ben Harris. Hey, are you all happy tonight? Amen. God wish to bless you. Huh? What can I say? Yes, sir, brother. You need to pray for me. Amen. Well, I want to bring, first of all, greetings to all of you in the name of Jesus Christ. It's been wonderful being once more in Ben Harris, 2008. This is my first time. And like Brother Belomo said, the devil fought me from coming here, but I was predestined. Hey, hallelujah, glory to God. So it matters not what the consulate said. It was what God said. And that must stand, amen. So thank God I'm here tonight. Have you seen that? I want to thank Brother Coleman. Amen. This is my first time of meeting him personally. And that has been my heartfelt desire to meet this great servant of God. I mean, eagle eye looking at eagle eye. So the eagle saw the eagle, brother. And that was something else. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. Omnipotent met omnipotent. And the miraculous is about to take place. Hallelujah. Glory. You may be seated. Amen. So I want to appreciate his ministry very, very much. Amen. His ministry has been of a blessing to my life personally, and my family, and my country, Sierra Leone. Because I know in that country, God is going to adopt somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. So if you see that, so I want to thank him very much for his labors. His labors of love all through these years, 34 years. He's been through cursings, revilings, all kinds of things for having re-echoing what the prophet said. And it was all being that we should be here today. And so may God richly bless him. We are looking forward for his healing. It's not too late yet. The convention is still on. Amen. So get out of the humanistic realm. Anything can take place, brother. We're on the third phase. Hallelujah. All things are possible to them that believe. Maybe see that. Amen. So I want to thank him very much for his invitation. To me, I mean, this is a privilege, honor for me to stand here and to speak to the bride of Christ, to a portion of the bride of Christ here in Ben Harris. Amen. I want to also thank the New York ministry. I mean, Brother Bill O'Moore. He's been a great soldier. He's been a great brother. He stood by the angel. He stood by this ministry. He's been so faithful. He's been so loyal. He's been a direct witness. Hallelujah. So God bless you, Brother Belomo and Brother Fury. Amen. Gallant soldiers. And also these young men here, Brother Joey and Brother Chima. I appreciate you, Brother Brancott, for your stand all these years. Taking your stand with the angel, not with a man, but with the angel. And in this adoption season, in this harvest season, God shall reward you. Amen. Oh, glory. Amen. I want to also thank God for, I mean, Brother Tim Smith. I mean, Brother Tim and Brother Knight Goiko, they've been, I don't know how to say. But these are two young men that have blown this message into a dimension. Brother Tim and Brother Knight. Amen. Special gift to the brother of Jesus Christ. May God bless them for standing with the angel. Oh, hallelujah, glory. And for all you ministers, for bringing your churches and making this convention graceful. May God richly bless you. May we see them. I want you to see also about our specials. I mean, there's something always about New York. When they sing, it's something else. When they preach, it's something else. When they dance, it's something else. There's just something always special about New York. Amen. And we have seen that with our eyes. We are witnesses. Amen. So we thank God for all the specials. The Sunday school children from the first of the convention. I want to also thank God for the special yesterday, even tonight. Amen. Yes, it's the blood of Jesus. You touch the hem of his garment. And virtue flows out from that garment. Amen. So thank God for the special tonight. You be seated. Amen. So what comment can I make on the messages that has gone ahead of me? I mean, these are mind-blowing. Hallelujah. But that night's message on the first of the convention, that message was wonderful. That message had set a tone for what God is going to do in these meetings. The three-level key to the Ephesians. And now the three-level key is turned to one-level key on the third phase. Brotherly kindness. Say amen. If you can only find that. Amen. If we can only find that. Say amen. Say amen. Oh, glory. And we've been called to a Jordan to a showdown. Because only the bride can forgive. So brotherly kindness will separate the shock from the wheat. Because the shock cannot forgive. They will hold on to grudges. Say amen. Because love will only be in the bride. Hallelujah. And by this shall all men know you are my disciples. If you love one another. Hallelujah. That's the sign of your discipleship. Hallelujah. May we see that. So we are right in the separation line. So that message was a challenge. It will separate the true wheat, true seed, one bride, and the shock in the message. So I hope you understand that. You may be seeing the glory to God. Amen. You have to be a true disciple to forgive. Oh, hallelujah. Because brotherly kindness will pick back the spoken word. Say amen. If you say to this mountain, but that faith is based on forgiveness. You can't have that faith to speak to mountains if your faith is not based on forgiveness. That's the seed sown for the age by Malachi 4. You can't get around it. Say amen. We must take back brotherly kindness for our day, for our season. That's your virtue power. That's the thunder that shook this. Amen. Glory. My. Oh, maybe see that. So brotherly kindness was only identified in the fourth phase. But really, brother, you could not have picked that up until you come to the third phase. Because you were not even in position to forgive. So now the third phase is here. Place you in to forgive. To drop your hearts. Because dynamics is here to empower you to go to your brother and say, I forgive you. I don't care what he has done to you. I forgive you. You are my brother. Hallelujah. So the third phase is here now. Amen. Glory. Glory. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. That's why the third phase is so important. Because God ordained that you must come to the third phase. So manifest them virtues. Oh, hallelujah, glory. You may be seated, amen. So thank God we are here. We fought away 200,000 demons to get here. Now you can see your predestination. Now you can be sealed. Now you can be adopted. Now you can be filled and refilled. Now you can be perfect. Hallelujah. You fought all the interpretations of the message to be here this day. Oh, you need to know what this means. what the Father Faith really means, brother. This is time for inheritance. It's time for redemption. It's time for freedom. Hallelujah. It's angel season. It's Holy Spirit season. It's dynamic season, brother. Glory be to God. So we know where we are at. Oh, that's why we shout hallelujah, brother. Amen. Your wandering days are over. Your suffering is over. Hallelujah. Because Christ himself will drop down and set you free. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. You cannot be lost. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We know who we are, brother. We've seen our names in that book. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And on the third face, God shall manifest that name. Then you shall know you are in the Father, and the Father is in you. It is a finished work. We are always in Elohim, always in the Logos. Hallelujah. This day. Hallelujah. Oh. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. So God bless you, brother, now for that great showdown. So now we are in a showdown, and you can't escape anymore. You've been caught. So you either forgive and be a bright material, or you hold your grudges and be a shock. Well, I'm going to forgive anyway, because I've got to be in the bride. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. May God turn tonight to a night of bath pains. May God turn this room to a labor room, where many of you shall be born again and know that there is a God. We don't serve a dead God. We serve a living God. May God give you an experience of the Holy Ghost baptism, that you may know that we are serving the God of Malachi 4. And that God is not dead. That God is alive. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. After Malachi 4 left, that God did not leave. That God stayed behind to pull out your name out of the book of redemption. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So while we remain standing right away, because already I'm in the spirit. Oh, glory. Amen. Yes, sir. Shall we turn to Romans 8? Glory, glory, glory. I'm feeling fine tonight. I feel demons are going to scream. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So let every door be open tonight for exit of every demon power. Glory! Do you feel that way, church? Do you feel that way? Well, so shall it be. That's your decree, and so shall it be. Amen. Romans said, oh, remind me. Yes, sir. Romans 8, 28 and 29, Ephesians 4, 11 through 13, and Revelation 10, 8 through 11. It reads in this wise. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Amen. So to be conformed to the image of his Son is a predestination. Amen. So you can get around it. That's the purpose of your calling. That's why you're here tonight. So you came to Malachi for the message. You came, why? Because you are called to be formed into the image of his Son. Amen. And the guys in this message deny that. I'll say amen. But that's your calling. That's your commission. And if God commissions you, it's got to anoint you for the commission. So on the third phase, it drops down the anointing for the commission. Hallelujah. Because the commission alone cannot do it. So you've got to be commissioned and anointed. All say amen. All glory to God. To come to perfection. Amen. Glory, Ephesians 4 through 11. Yes, sir. Are you feeling good? Oh. Glory, Ephesians 4 through 11. Yes, sir, that we're done. Okay. 11 through 13. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfection of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Amen. Till we all come into the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Revelation 18, 8 through 11, quickly. Glory. And the voice which I heard from heaven spake unto me again, and said, go and take the little book which is open in the hand of the angel which standeth upon the sea and upon the earth. And I went unto the angel and said unto him, give me the little book. And he said unto me, take it and eat it up, and it shall make thy belly bitter, but it shall be in thy mouth sweet as honey. And I took the little book out of the angel's hand and ate it up, and it was in my mouth sweet as honey. And as soon as I had eaten it, my belly was bitter. And he said unto me, thou must prophesy again before many peoples and nations and tongues and kings. Father, we thank you, God, for the night. We've just read a portion of your word, Lord. We pray that you may drop down, Lord, the anointing that you promised your people for that tonight. Lord, that anointing that will enable them to grow into the stature of Jesus Christ. We thank you for, Lord, we are here today under great expectations, Father. For those who have not been born again without an experience, I pray, Father, tonight, that, Lord, you may drop down with the Holy Ghost, Lord, Father, and give them, Lord, an experience, Father. Those who've been born again, may you refill them tonight, Lord. May we leave this place, Lord, with a charge to move on with you, Father. How we thank you for all of things, for we ask all these things in Jesus' most precious name. Amen and amen and amen. You may be seated. I have a little title for you. I may not stay too long, predestinated to be formed into the word image on the bright star face. Amen. That's my title. My inspiration is, we are changing over from the apostolic echo of Revelation 10, 8 through 11 to a manifestation of the prophet prophecy. So we are not here tonight to echo any ministry anymore. We change from that. Now we're crossing over Jordan. Say amen. Oh, say amen. Oh, glory to God. Amen. The apostolic echo has been made plain. We know what the apostolic echo is. That's already finished. Now we're crossing over. Say amen. Do you understand that? So a key has been torn in this convention. Hallelujah, glory to God, for God to drop down the ministry of the spirits. In Ephesians, and form you into the word image. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Amen. Now we are in Malachi 4's message proper. All these years has been a groundwork. Now we are in the message proper. The glorious, wonderful, baptism of the Holy Ghost, where there is virtue and knowledge and temperance and patience. Now we are there. Oh, hallelujah. You can now arise and shine, for the glory of God is upon thee. Malachi, for release that glory on his third pool. Hallelujah. And that became the fourth light. Amen. That glory was revealed as a seven seal, seven thunder message. But that was the headstone. Amen. He had that as word and spirit. But it was disguised as a seven seal message. And the bride will reach to a spot where they will see that glory. That Holy Spirit itself, which is the image of Jesus Christ. Say amen. That will be loose under the seventh seal, and that will form you into the image of Jesus Christ, the image that you were before you came here. And that's the message. Let me see that. Amen. 1906 was for above. Amen. But to be formed into the word image was a mystery. Because that brings you back to sonship. Oh, say amen. Say amen. That was the image of God released under the seals. And that's been misunderstood in the message. Have you seen it? Oh, have you seen it a little bit? Say amen. Amen. Oh, glory. So the bride has come to our third phase, third step, where by faith we believe God can release this anointing, this spirit, amen, upon your word seeds and turn those word seeds into word images, amen, and get you prepared for the rapture. Oh, hallelujah. So an echo ministry was only to let you see that section in the prophet's message, because that went to make the book of redemption in the prophet's message. Revelation 10:7 revealed all seals. It revealed all life. The shock life, the tassel life, ecumenical life, and it was all revealed. Because it was sent to finish all the mysteries. But in those mysteries was the redemptive life, which was your life. The life of Jesus Christ was also hidden there. And you may be seated. The only life that comes back, the life of Jesus. So in his message, we are angels, charity, headstone, Holy Spirit itself. That all went to make the book of redemption. So an apostle came behind it to cut that book in Malachi 4's message. That you might see your name in the book. And that became an echo. So in that book is charity. In that book is angels. In that book is headstone. In that book is adoption. In that book is perfection. That all goes to make the book of redemption. Is the life of Jesus Christ. In that book is Elohim. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In that book is seven spirit. It was all in that book. Hallelujah. And that became your name. Your name is Jesus Christ. Your name is his life. Everything in that book is yours. Oh, here is saying now. So there had to come an apostolic echo for you to even see your name, or else you will not have been able to know what your name is. But now we know we are not shocked, we are bride, because we have seen our names in the eternal section of the book of life. Hallelujah. We are not church members, we are the bride of Jesus Christ. We are Elohim's thoughts expressing the Logos. Hallelujah. We have angels. We have charity, adoption, perfection. We have all that. So when you see the apostolic echo, then you see your name in the message. Oh, glory to God. That's why we preach adoption. We preach perfection. We preach angels. We preach adoption. We preach Elohim. That's the book of life. And that's the only life that comes back. Any other life is annihilated in hell. It doesn't come back. The shock life shall be annihilated. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The church life shall be annihilated. But the bride's life will come back. And we shall reign on the earth as kings and priests. Who's going to stop that, brother? No demon can stop that, because God said so. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Do you understand now? So for the past 34 years, it has been trying to cut that book. Trying to pull that book from the book of life, the book of redemption, from the book of life. So the book of redemption has come to us in this form. It's all here. Your redemptive rights. Your seven seals right. Your angelic positions. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Where was thou when all the sons of God shouted for joy? Hallelujah. Glory to God. You fought Lucifer. You fought two-thirds of the angels in your angelic position with Michael, the voice of the archangel. You're going back to that in the third phase. Hallelujah, glory to God. God will send down your minister with spirit. Angels will descend from heaven and empower you to defeat Satan once more. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. So now we thank God. We know where we are standing. So in the prophet's message, we have a position in the message. Yes, amen. And that message separates the shock from the wheat. Because you deny seven thunders, adoption, perfection, angels, Elo, you deny that, then that's Jesus Christ you denying. Oh, do you understand that now, church? Who do you say this is? Oh, glory to God, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So now the book of redemption is moving over to Ephesians. So in Ephesians, we are looking for angels, headstone, capstone, adoption, perfection in Ephesians. Because the angel goes over with the book. And no shock. Hallelujah. Glory to God. No church member. It's only bride member. Because you have your name in that book. So on the third phase, you shall be manifested. Hallelujah. Charity, adoption, perfection will be your inheritance. Oh, so you took a glorious stand for your inheritance and they fought you all these years. But thank God you stood. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. So the book of redemption went forth as an apostolic echo, which was also a prophecy of the Malachi 4th prophecy. Say amen. It was only a prophecy of the prophet's prophecy. But it had to change from the prophet to his prophecy. But that was a bride's prophecy. That's you. That you shall come forth. You shall be sealed. You shall be adopted. Perfected. It went forth as a prophecy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Now we are here. We've turned the corner now. Now the same angel now comes forth to manifest Malachi 4's prophecy into a manifestation. Hallelujah. Glory. Then that becomes the voice of the archangel. Then this whole world will know that you met a prophet. You may be seated. Oh, I want us to nail these things down. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. So the voice angel now moves over. That's Michael. That means Michael is going to be positioned in Ephesians 4 himself. From Daniel 12 to Ephesians 4. That's his position. Amen. Then through a fivefold. Amen. Charity himself being the voice of the archangel will be there. Amen. And will be losing first those virtues. This glorious, wonderful, bow to the Holy Ghost. And form his church into his one image. Then he will rebuild his church by virtue power. Amen. Like Brother Blumber said, it won't have to do with you. It will be he himself. Because he rebuilds the church. Amen. But you must know where you are at. And that must put some reverence in you. Hallelujah. Put you on fire. That's how you know you're on the third phase. That the word is open to you. Say amen. It puts you on fire. It makes you pray. Because you know what it is. That we can't get nowhere if those virtues are not formed in you. Amen. So the third phase should first of all place us into position for this great manifestation. And many are not there yet. Because if you are there, then they won't tell you to shout. They won't coerce you to come to church. Your understanding will be open. You will know these virtues must be in me or I'm going nowhere. And if you are going nowhere, it means you are heading for the great tribulation. Then that puts you on fire. Then you won't be a dead church member anymore. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When Jesus Christ opened the eyes of the disciples, without tragedy coming down yet, but by the word was so open to them that that understanding placed them on fire. It placed them in position for charity. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Then we are in the upper room on fire, praying, making supplications, because their understanding was open. Hallelujah. They locked themselves up there, praying, hollering for God to send down the fire. Hallelujah. Before the Holy Ghost even fell. That's how you know that your understanding is open up. Outside that, it still shows you are not at the third phase yet. Oh, let somebody say amen. Oh, glory to God. So the third phase was to open up our understanding first as to what this whole thing has been. Because Malachi 4 already placed us into zero hour. With a shout message, it says potentially we are in the rapture. Somebody say amen. So right now we are in the rapture. But that is not real to many of you here tonight. Say amen. And so you're in and out of the church, doing this and doing that. But on this third phase, he comes down, amen, and opens your understanding that you might know that already we are in the rapture. Hallelujah, glory to God. The time is fleeting out, and that puts you on fire. Hallelujah. So pray for the Holy Ghost. Lord, let me be born again. Lord God, seal me. Hallelujah. Then that puts you in position for charity. Glory to God. We must go back to the apostolic times. Oh, amen. So Jesus Christ came back 40 days. He built them, opened their understanding to understand what the old thing was all about. Then they saw their name. Then they realized the need for the Holy Spirit. They knew they could get nowhere without charity. They saw the need, hallelujah. So they locked themselves up in the upper room with supplications, hallelujah. Thank their faith bank was high. That was how we know that we are on their own third phase to be hooked into dynamics. Hallelujah, glory to God. Amen. So this third phase places you in position for God's great manifestation. It makes you drop your heart. It makes you forgive. You put everything right. Thank you, Jesus Christ. That's how you know that you have an understanding of what the third phase is. Oh, somebody say amen. Oh, hallelujah, glory. Then you are placed in position for dynamics. Because the Holy Ghost can't come on hurts and grudges and backbitings and evil surmisings. It can't come on that. It has to come on the word. How glory to God. Hallelujah. So you are prepared by the word to put you on fire, to be on the beam. Hallelujah. The right attitude, right approach to the seventh seal, with reverence, with respect. Hallelujah. With cries and weepings and so forth. For charity to come down. Then you are prepared for dynamics. Then you know I'm now on the third phase. Hallelujah, glory. Then anytime from now you can be hooked into the voice of the archangel, we put you into the coming of the law. Oh, glory. Hallelujah, glory. Then his coming becomes a reality. Then you know I'm in the rapture. Hallelujah. Then the things of the world are gone. Sex is gone. All the glamour is gone. All the backbitings are gone. You're on your way to the resurrection. Hallelujah, glory. Shouting and praising God. Looking forward for God's rap. Hallelujah, glory. There's no more time for the things of the world. You're on the rapture train express. You're on your way. That all the things of America cannot pin you down. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Machanda, machanda. Say amen. Hallelujah. Glory. So, but the common's desire has been that the people understand what the third phase is. So when he says we are signs of the third phase, you understand what the third phase is. place in Christ get you in position to be placed. They said, but the not brought the first day, he brought brotherly kindness to get you in position, because charity can't fall on ought. It can't fall on grudges. It can't fall on malice. It can't fall on resentment. Hallelujah, glory to God. That was to prepare you for great dynamics, brother. I don't care what you say, the power of God is going to fall. Hallelujah, charity is going to fall, because Malachi 4 said so, because God said so. Hallelujah, glory. There's going to be a glorious church. I don't care what you say, unbelief cannot stop God. Hallelujah, we are going to the resurrection. There's going to be a rapture. Hallelujah. So you better believe it. That's my heart. Amen. Oh, glory. So we are here to preach you the third phase, that your understanding will be open to what it has all been since 1963. That we have been zeroed into zero hour. So anytime from now, California can sink. Say amen. Anytime from now, there can be a rapture, brother. Hallelujah. We are already in the rapture. Potentially, we are there by a short message. Then the voice comes down to make that message real to you. Then he sets your heart on fire. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Then he puts you on the bridge. Hallelujah. 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 No more time for demons. No more time for sin. No more time for ungodliness. You are free. Oh, hallelujah, glory. You young people, come on. Say amen. This is your time. This is your season. The devil has pinned you down for so long, but you have been zeroed into the rapture. I don't care what you say. Your name is in the book. And the devil cannot pin you down. He cannot pin you down. You are going to be free tonight. Hallelujah. God will baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. He will seal your way. Oh, hallelujah. There is not enough devils in America to stop you, brother, because you are predestinated. 200,000 demons cannot stop you. Hallelujah. 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 Because your name is in the book. Your name is in the book. And tonight I defy every devil that you are going to go free. You are going to be redeemed. You will live here today with a change of heart. You will hate the things of the world. You will hate the glamour. You will love Jesus. Glory to God. The devil thinks he's getting his way, but he's not getting his way. We will get our way, because we are predestinated. The Holy Ghost is here. You can get your way. The devil is a liar, he's a failure. He cannot get his way. We are going to undo everything he has done. Shut! Hallelujah! Everything he has done, we are going to undo it back. Undo it back. Undo it back. You are sons of God. You are sons of God. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Oh, glory. Copy Dumba. Let me tell you something. When God gives you an experience, a lot of times the enemy comes and runs you down, makes you fall back into your carnal nature, and lets you think nothing happened. He tries to run down and undo what God has done. But in your heart, you know something happened to me. Well, in this season, we are going back to undo what he has done. And let you know, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can't backslide. You can't go back, young man. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You backsliders, come back. You are sons of God. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar. Your name is in the book. Hallelujah. Glory. You are bound for heaven. Yes. That's the devil's tactics. He tells young people, nothing happened to you. Did you think you something happened to you? It makes you doubt your experience. And tells you it was all a myth. But you are a witness that something happened to me, brother. Something took place. But you refuse to come into terms with your God-given experience. But on this third phase, the Holy Ghost is here to bring you back into terms with your experience. Hallelujah. If God saved you, live like one who is saved. Hallelujah. Glory. If God has set you free, then live like that. Because God has already done it. But you've got to accept it by faith. By faith. By faith I'm saved. By faith I'm sealed. By faith I'm delivered. Accept it by faith. Because that's your name. Glory to God. No matter how the devil makes you feel, he's a liar. Hallelujah, glory. It makes you feel depressed, makes you feel oppressed, but he's a liar. You have been delivered, you have been saved. Hallelujah, glory. You can laugh to his face. You are a liar, Satan. God has delivered me. You can take me back. So we're closing every room for backsliders. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. God saved me in 1983. That's my testimony. I fought my way 2008. But everything that God killed since 1983 has never come back. But I have to fight to keep that which God gave me. Because I knew 83, something happened to me. Oh, say amen. I was in the Pentecostal church, but I knew something took place. I knew something happened. Hallelujah. I've kept that. So you keep that which God gave you, young man. If God saved you, keep that. Don't let some oppression take it away from you. If God delivered you, keep that. I don't care how bad you feel, how oppressed you feel, keep that. Because God already gave you that. Hallelujah, glory to God. If you have the Holy Ghost, keep that. Hallelujah. We are tearing down Satan tonight. Tearing down his thoughts on young people. Because we know his devices. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. I have a message. My message has been one message. The baptism of the Holy Ghost. An experience with God. Once you have that, you finish. Something you can always relate with. You can always go back to, brother. Once you have that finished, brother, the devil can lie to you. Amen. And that's the only message in the land that will change your life. The experience of the Holy Ghost baptism that makes you know there's a God somewhere. And tonight I challenge you. Hallelujah. And all these men here with the Holy Ghost are challenging you that you can be sealed. You can receive the Holy Ghost. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? God is more than able to give you an experience that will make you die to the things of the world. My God can do it. My God can do it. The new birth is the foundation. Hallelujah. That has got to be laid first. Oh, hallelujah. And I'm trusting God that God cannot live in the same way. Hey, let me see that. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Are you in the spirit now? Amen. Is your heart changed? You want the Holy Ghost? You want to be sealed? Then it's just for you to be sealed tonight. Hallelujah. That's God's program for your life. And that's the message for today. Amen. Oh, Malachi 4:7, the message came down in the form of a baptism. The seven seals is experience. So you can't explain that. Like my 19 said this morning, you believe in God for something, what you believe in God for? For a manifestation. An experience. So your faith turns into an experience. Then that becomes an anchor. And the devil cannot tell you lies on that. Because you know that you know that it happened. God makes you a direct witness of what he does in you. Oh, say amen. Oh, glory to God. Amen. Amen. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So now we're moving on. Hallelujah. So Malachi 4 moved us from 1906, the new birth, your first experience of being born again. Then to your birth, you add seven things, which is the image. Amen. But in this message, you come into this message, then the Holy Ghost comes upon you under the seventh seal, then it puts in you a bath at the same time power. Because the Holy Ghost you are receiving has virtue, knowledge, temperance in it, which is the spirit of adoption. You understand that? So now in this message, when you are born again, you are born again, but at the same time you receive virtue, power, amen, into your bath. Power to grow. Power to deny those demons. Those sex demons. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. It makes you grow. It forms you into the image of Jesus Christ, which is the perfection. Amen. And that was the faith, the Holy Ghost that God gave to the early church. Acts chapter 2. Amen. 2:38. The glorious, wonderful baptism of the Holy Ghost that has virtues in it. And that came down, it gave them not only a bath, but it also adopted them. It gave them power, amen, to add Jesus Christ upon their new bath. It formed them to the image of Jesus Christ. And that glorious baptism of the Holy Ghost was spanned out in seven church ages. And Malachi 4 came back and gathered it all up under the seventh seal. And he released that to you as dynamic to your mechanics. It became a promise. So if it's a promise, somebody had to contend for it. Because God said so. So for all these years, we have been contending for this Holy Ghost itself, not only for a bath, but to form you into the image of Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Not just with a bath and doing all kinds of things in the message, but a bath plus virtue in your bath to make you live like a Christian, talk like a Christian. Hallelujah. Then they see Jesus Christ reflecting himself in you. They see Christ walking out of your life. Oh, hallelujah. Then all men shall know that you have been with Jesus. Because they will see his life projecting out of you. His glory will rise upon you. They will see Jesus Christ in you, talking in you, moving in you. Hallelujah. That's Christianity. And we must come back to that. Malachi 4 restored us back to that, back to the apostolic faith. Oh, hallelujah, glory. So for the past 34 years, that has been the contention, contending for this seventh seal, for this glory that we once had with God before the world began. Seven rainbow spirits, seven rainbow glory, seven spirits of perfection. Hallelujah, glory to God. Amen. 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 so you can stay in your humanistic realm. Because your human spirit was only given you to be here on this earth. And sometimes when you die, it breaks up. Because you must know your Elohim series. Way back there, it was Elohim and Logos. Nothing else. And that was seven spirits and Logos world. So nothing else go back there without seven spirits and Logos world. No human spirits. No concept, no reasoning. It was Holy Spirit, seven Elohim spirit and Logos. Oh, say amen. Seven perfect spirits. Hallelujah, glory to God. Amen. Because you cannot see God. St. John 1 says, he said, amen, amen. No man has ever seen God. So the only way God expressed himself was by an image. So he formed himself into an image. And that image was him revealed. That when you see the image, you see the invisible God. So Jesus Christ was that image that revealed the invisible God. And Abraham said, neither do you also see me. Then who are you? Oh, say amen. You are not this human being that you see. You are not a human spirit. Hallelujah. You were seven spirits way back in Elohim. Then seven spirits spoke to Logos, let us make man in our image and likeness. So that's where your word image is coming from. Say amen. Seven spirits, Elohim spoke to Logos, let's make man. So God made man in his image. Because his image was himself revealed. The invisible made visible. And that image was projected in flesh. It became Jesus Christ. Oh, say amen. And this is the only thing that goes back into the rapture, brother. Nothing else goes back. Hallelujah, glory. That's why we know who we are. We know where we are coming from. We have an Elohim revelation of what it was way back there. Then the devil cannot lie to you anymore. You've got to leave your humanistic realm and be born again. And so that's why we emphasize the new birth. Oh, come on, somebody say amen. Oh, come on, somebody say amen. You must see this image and why you need to possess this image. Hallelujah. Amen. That became the word image. So man was made in that word image. Elohim spoke to Logos, let make man. And that became a theophany, the glory of God. And that image was supposed to be projected into flesh. Say amen. Say amen. But man failed. Man bypassed that. Then God sent you a prophet with the book of redemption to reveal to you how you can get back to that image. And that became a seven seals message. But that was a hidden mystery. Oh, say amen. How to get back to that image, that word image, which is your real you. And so that's why we try to break up your human spirit, because you are not there. Break up your humanistics. Break up your feelings. What you see, what you feel, break that up and be born. Hallelujah. Then you go back to where you were. You go back to your father. You go back to your image, because that is your predestination. Oh, somebody say amen. Now we see where we are going, brother. Hallelujah, glory. So your Elohim revelation let you know that. And that was the importance of that revelation. Because it shows you exactly how you came about. It must be word and spirit. That was the only thing that was there. No reasoning, no imagination, no coin. Nah, that was in there. That was given to you when you came here. Hallelujah, glory to God. But God put a seed in your soul. something in you that can be redeemed. Like Brother 19 said this morning, a word seed that could be formed. Then that makes you redeemable. Outside of that, you can't come back. You remain in the humanistic. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. This was the image that Adam lost, because he lost the book of redemption. Redemption, the seals, God gave Adam the book of seals, because in that book was a revelation to make sons of God. She was to make sons of God from that book. Amen. That was sealed in there. So he lost the book. And the book went back to God. Say amen. Then he could only bring forth flesh sons. They lost the image. Then the humanistic image came upon your flesh. Because your human spirit is also an image. But it's humanistic. And God has his own image. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But God promised, I will restore. I will restore back that image. I'll bring you back to where you should be. I'll bring you back to sons of God. Hallelujah, glory. He restored that by a seven seals message in our time. Oh, hallelujah. Let me see them. And that becomes the perfection. So that image of seven speaking and logos is the perfection. Your theophany. The logos word. Word and spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. And God brought you here to be tempted by sin. But when your training is over, you go back to the word. You pick back your theophany. But before you do that, you must first be formed, conformed into that image. You must look like your theophany. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So amen, amen, amen. Oh, hallelujah, glory. Amen. Now you see that? But I'm saying perseverance. I don't keep it long. He said, I believe that there's a church coming into that perfection. You believe that as well? Amen. There's a church coming to that perfection. That ministry of perfection. We are the officers, the apostles, and the prophets, and teachers, and pastors, and evangelists. Amen. For the perfection of the church. Then pastors and teachers and so forth. Will be so with the word until the whole thing will walk right up into the coming of the Lord. I believe that, and I believe we are nearing that time now. Amen. And that's the only hope left in this time is for God to bring forth this ministry of perfection. Amen. To bring you back to perfection. And that's a promise for you in the message. The morning star. Amen. Hallelujah. The ministry of the Spirit. That's the only promise left. And it will come down as charity. So it's not a man. Jesus Christ himself is the fivefold. Do you believe that? So the fivefold ministry is Christ. Not Brother John. Not Brother Coleman. Is Christ. Charity is the fivefold ministry. Five manifestations of the Holy Spirit. So bring it to perfection. The Holy Ghost does all. That is all in your dynamics. To your mechanics. Hallelujah. Oh glory. That's the ministry of the Spirit. And Jesus must bring that. And that's why he has to move over to Ephesians 4 to bring that. Because no man can do that. Hallelujah, glory. He has to move over to Ephesians 4. Hallelujah, and manifest himself in five offices. Then he brings you to perfection. Because he says, I will build my church. He does the rebuilding of the church through five offices. So it's Christ doing the work. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. In this adoption season, amen. And we believe he has connected to Ephesians 4. Then the Ephesians 4 is the mechanics. So Ephesians 4 is already in you as mechanics. The word. Then he comes to operate that. Then the spirit in the fivefold will say what? The same to the bride in you. Because the word already is in you. Then the bride and the spirit say the same thing. The word bride in you and the spirit in the fivefold will say the same thing. Because the bride won't in his mechanics. And here comes someone with the spirit. Amen. That we shall say the same thing. And the same thing is perfection, adoption. Amen. Being formed into his word image. Oh, say amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then the spirit and the bride say, come. Charity and the word in the bride say, come. Mechanics, dynamics together. The groom and the bridegroom. The bridegroom and the groom. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The husband and his wife. Christ and the faithful in you. That's a meeting. Then he comes and meets with his word in you. And forms you to his own very word image. Transforms you. That is what you are expecting in this season. Say amen. Amen. This is the third phase revelation seeds. And that puts you under expectation, not under imagination. Then you know it can happen anytime from now because God said so. It puts you under expectation. Because the word is in the bride echoing, cooing for the husband. Calling for the spirit. Calling for the life. Hallelujah. The word in you calling for the life of the world. And when that comes together, it brings forth another son of God. Oh, then it's no more the individual. He becomes a son of God. He becomes an image of God. He becomes Christ in human veil. Christ in human vessel. Do you believe that? Oh, so on this third phase, we are putting you under expectation. Like Simeon. The Holy Ghost revealed to Simeon that he will not die, but he will live to see the lost Christ. That was not imagination. That was expectation. It was revealed by the Holy Spirit. Then one day the Holy Ghost came back. Hallelujah. And struck Simeon. Stand up. It's time for the promise. Hallelujah. So now we are under expectation that anything can take place. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In this hall, in your room, anything can happen because you are placed under expectation for dynamics to strike and change you. Oh, hallelujah, glory. This cannot be imagination. It's expectation. Because the prophet said so. It's Tosha the prophet. Hallelujah. I'm not imagining. I'm under expectation. Because if God said so, so shall it be. No demon can stop that. Your flesh cannot stop that. It's going to be. Oh, hallelujah, glory. And that should put all of us on fire. Every day, every night, raising your hands up. Say, Lord, I'm here. I'm a candidate for the Holy Ghost baptism. It puts you under charge. It puts you under expectation for anything to take place. Because you have been placed in position for dynamics on this third phase. That means now we are ready and let the fire fall. We have made everything right. Oh, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Oh, my. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We must come back to this perfection, brother. Amen. I'm saying perfect faith. We must come back to this perfection in order for the rapture. So there cannot be a rapture without the perfection. So we must come back to the perfection in order for the rapture. So we must have perfect faith to come to perfection. Your faith is resolved. I'm going to be perfect. I don't care what my flesh says. I'm going to be perfect. I don't care how I feel. I'm going to be perfect. I don't care what this one says, that one says. I'm going to be perfect. You are resolved. Because that is your age requirement. Oh, say amen. Oh, say amen. And the only way we can be perfect is to come back to those seven perfect spirits. Abraham's in Hebrews. So anything outside of that is only a perversion. So anything else in this message outside of that is only a perversion. But the prophet said the only way we can get a perfection is to get back to those seven perfect spirits. Anything outside that is only a perversion. Because that was what you were. Hallelujah. The word image. Hallelujah. Elohim spoke to Logos. Let's make man. That's your image. Holy Spirit is your image. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's what you are. You are the Holy Ghost. Your name in the book is the Holy Ghost. That's the only life that goes back. That's the only life that comes back and reigns on this earth. So you've got to have that life in you in order to come back and reign on this earth as kings and priests. And I'm going to preach that on the house roof. I'll preach that everywhere, that you've got to be born again to come back. Oh, glory, say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. And God still seals. God still seals. He still baptizes with the Holy Ghost. He's still in that business. Even tonight he can do so. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen. Glory, glory. So God has got to make a way for our perfection. So he made a way through the blood. That Brother Nantin preached this morning. And he put the blood in the book. And he gave the book to the prophet. And the air community went and took the book. So now we are here. So if we have the book, we can have the blood. And then in the blood is the life for perfection. That means God has made a way. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. The book in heaven came down. Amen. Malachi ever took that book. Because in that book was the blood. And in that blood was your name. And your name in the blood was a life. And the life of seven virtues. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus Christ. So God restored back the book. Hallelujah. Amen. 97:4. Somebody went forth and took back that book. Hallelujah. Because in that book is your name. In that book is the blood. Hallelujah. And all them virtues is in that book. It's in that blood. Hallelujah. Glory. Oh, thank you, Jesus Christ. And the blood is the spirit. That was God making a way. He opened the seventh seal and loosed the blood out. And this guy said the seventh seal is closed. How can I accept that? When I know God set me free in this message, you are a liar. The seventh seal is open. Hallelujah. Glory to God. People get sealed, get blessed, get delivered. You see the book is closed. It's not closed. Because deliverance can only come out from that book. And for those who have the Holy Ghost, you know the book is open. Because that Holy Ghost came from that book. Hallelujah, glory to God. If God has set you free, you know that book is open. It's not closed. Because we have signs that the book is open. Deliverance is going on. God is busy changing people, transforming your life from under that seal. So I am a witness that the book is not closed. And tonight you shall be a witness. The book is not closed. Because it shall deliver you. It will change you. It will manifest your name. Glory! That's why we rejoice, brother. We know where we are coming from. We have a life in us that came from that seal. Oh, thank you, Jesus. That we know our names was under that seal. You can change my mind. I know where I came from. I came from God, and I'm going back to God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. So God will stop back the book, and the book is now going over to Ephesians. Because this five ministry cannot preach without the book. Amen. Because they must preach the blood in the book to release the life that's in the blood. And that's how you tell them. They must preach from the book. Because the blood comes from the book. Because the token follows the blood all the way from the book of redemption. Oh, somebody say amen. So this angel is moving over to Ephesians 4 with the open book and blood flowing out of that book. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Amen. So the blood itself is the Ephesians, because this virtue flows into you through that blood. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory. How thankful we are that God will stop back the book. Oh, hallelujah. A book of angels, a book of seals. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Let me finish my note quickly. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. 10 more minutes. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Ooh. Glory. Amen. So on the third phase, there comes the angel. Because you are predestinated to receive these virtues, to be formed in this image on the bright third phase. That means your name will be manifested on the third phase. When the two spies went to Cana, they met Rahab the harlot. Now Rahab's name was under the seventh seal. So she was given a sign as a token. But the token itself could not deliver her. But she expressed her faith in the message of the spies by applying the token. But her deliverance could not be manifested. She has to wait. So as soon as the spies left, she applied the token. So she kept herself alive under the token. She has no clue as to when the spies will return. But she had faith in that message of the spies. So there was a season that the spies gave Rahab the token. But there was no manifestation. Say amen. So she stayed alive under the token. Having faith in the token. Amen. Then come the season. The spies came. And she had no idea when they would return. And when the spies returned, you know Joseph's commission. It was to march around the city once a day on the 7 days, seven times. But Rahab's manifestation, her deliverance, was hidden on the seventh day and on the seventh march. So she had to wait under the token. Then the march on the fourth day, nothing happened. But she still held on to the token. Hallelujah. She had a sign that if God was going to redeem 10,000 people in Kenya, she was amongst them. She had a sign that if it would take one man, she was also among them. She has a sign of redemption. She had a sign, hallelujah, that if two people are going to be redeemed, I am one of them. Because she had a sign. She knew if it was one person, it would be me, Rahab. Because she had a sign. So she had faith in the sign. But nothing still happened. The matter first day, nothing happened. Second day, third day, fourth day, fifth day. Then come the seventh day. March found six times, nothing happened. Because she was ordained to be delivered on the seventh march. And when they marched on the seventh time, on the seventh day, the angelical wall fell down. Then what? A salvation was manifested. Hallelujah, glory to God. She was delivered. Then she changed from the token to a manifestation. Oh, say amen. And I believe all these years we've been under the token of the two witnesses, Malachi 4 and the apostolic, with a sign that we shall be delivered, brother. You're going to be set free. And we have stayed true to the sign. A sign and evidence that there is deliverance, there is redemption, there is perfection. God gave us a sign by the prophetic and the apostolic, two live witnesses for our day. Hallelujah, glory to God. And we have stayed on the side of talking of what we have seen and heard. And the token, the evidence of the resurrection of the new land has kept us alive. Maybe you are here for all these years, nothing has happened to you. But you held on to the token. What you saw happen in the prophet life. What you saw happen in New York. You saw God did that. You saw God did that. You're holding on. You have a sure sign that one day my turn will come. One day I shall be delivered. One day I shall be free. You held on. So we are holding on to the token because you are predestinated that on the third phase, on the seventh March, your name shall be manifested. Oh, hallelujah. Could it be this day? Could it be this time? We have held on to the token. Hallelujah. The evidence of the new land. But today we shall possess the land itself. Not just by some evidence, but the land itself. Oh, glory to God. And Rahab is a bride type. Say amen. It's only a bride type. And it shows you what predestination also is. So don't you walk away. You're walking away for hold on to your token. You have seen too much to walk away. You have seen six spoken word signs. Hallelujah, glory to God, that God can heal, God can create organs. That is a sign, a token. Oh, glory to God, how can you see that and walk away? Walk away where? You have seen God raise the dead, the blind see. Hallelujah, that's a sign. Hallelujah, that on this third phase, the blind eyes shall open, the lame shall walk, the dead shall be raised, and you shall be filled with the Holy Ghost. No doubt about that. Hallelujah. So stay under the token. Glory! I'm not moving an inch. I'm going to stay here until God deliver me. I will not move an inch. I'm going to stay here until God sets me free. I don't care how bound you are. God can deliver you. God can set you free. God can break every chain. We have a sign. We have a sign. God bless you.
Of God. Oh, hallelujah, devil, you're finished. You cannot stop me. You will not stop me. I am going to be filled. I am going to be delivered. This is my night. This is my night. This is my night. For the ones without the Holy Ghost, you lift your voices, you begin to pray for these young people, pray for the ones without the Holy Ghost. Oh, hallelujah, praise God, amen. Ministering brother, lift your voices, cry out for the people. Father, seal these people, Lord. Deliver the captives, Lord. There is nothing that can stop you this evening. I don't care where you're sitting. I don't care what you've done. You're not too far gone. God can do anything. God can reach anybody. Hallelujah. This is your night. Don't listen to anything that the devil has to say. That this is not your night. This is your night. You are free this evening. I challenge you to believe it. I challenge you, young people. You young men in the front here. Grab a hold of that angel. Don't let him go. Grab a hold of that angel. He's standing right next to you. Yourself. Break past yourself. Forget about who's around you. Begin to cry with all that is within you. Oh God, somebody's praying, Lord. Come by here. Somebody needs you, Lord. Come by here. Oh, break past your natural self. I wouldn't care how I look. I wouldn't care if my shirt was undone. I don't care if I'm in my dress. Hallelujah. But it's just, let me get that promise. Seal me, Father. Oh, little sister, deliverance is here for you. If you're in the back, hallelujah, lift up your voices. I don't care where you are in this building. The angel is walking up and down the aisle. He is walking up and down the aisle with your sealing. He's walking with your deliverance. Holy, holy, holy. He's coming. Don't you worry. Just hold on. Just hold on. Just hold on. Fill my brothers, Lord God. Fill my sisters, Lord God. Oh, you parents, you cry out for your children. You lift your voices, even if they're not here. But you have a promise that they will be here. Lift your voices in praise. Lift your voices, Lord God. My son is my promise. My daughter is my promise. I claim them in your name this evening. the holy plain, past the brazen altar. Lord, I want to see your face. Take me past the crowds of people and the priests that sing your praise. Lord, I hunger and thirst for righteousness, but it's only found one place. So take me in. Oh, deacons and ushers, you surround the people with your prayers. Hallelujah. Glory to God, amen. Just let go. Let go of yourself. Give your all to him. Give everything to him. About your mistakes. There is nothing against you this evening. There is nothing that can separate you from the love of God. Go to him. If you ask anything in my name, that will I do it. Convention, Father. Oh, I want more of you, Lord. I I want more of you in my life, Lord. Lord, I'm not satisfied with what I have, Lord. I want more, Father. I want less of me. I want more of you, Lord. That's growing inside of us, Lord Jesus. Oh, we can't live without it, Lord God. It's life to us, Lord. It's everything to us, Lord. Thank you. over the building. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Oh, we can't stop, Lord. We won't stop, Lord, until we're filled, Lord. Oh, God. Come, Lord Jesus. There's a deep calling to you this evening. Deepest calling to the deep.
Keep shouting. Shout down the walls of Jericho.
He has bid you to shout. He has bid you to rejoice. Nothing against you. Nothing against the word seed inside of you. Oh, hallelujah.
Turn around and greet your brother and sister. Go out of your way. If you're in the front, the sides, no matter where you are, go greet your brother and sister. Oh, you've broken through. Stay in that spiritual plane.
rejoicing. Appreciate the message by Brother Johnny Conte. We're destined to be formed into the word image on the third phase. Hallelujah. God bless you, Brother Johnny. Oh, you're going to be formed into the word image. You're going to make it. Hallelujah. Just before we get ready to close, I just want to sing this one last song. I know that I can make it. I don't care what the devil throws in our way. We are going to make it. There will be a perfect bride on the earth. And I'm going to be part of it. You speak it the same way. Be positive. I don't care how young you are or how old you are. I will be perfect. I will be adopted. I will be positionally placed. Hallelujah. You don't have to worry, and don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning, all your sorrow will pass away. For there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. Oh, and if your heart is broken, oh, just lift your hands and sing. Well, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, my life is in. Oh, and with Jesus I can take it. With Him I know I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, I know my life is in. So when your tests and trials, they seem to get you down, and all your friends and loved ones, they are nowhere to be found. Oh, remember there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away.
Glory! Hallelujah!
Oh, He's not finished yet this evening. Oh, Lord, well, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, I know my life. Oh, Lord, with Jesus I can take it. With Him I know I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, my life is in Your hand. Oh, let's give Him one final hand of praise. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Just keep playing softly. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, our hearts are bubbling over this evening, Lord.
Lord, some maybe, Lord, have received the Holy Ghost tonight. Lord, but that promise is hanging over us, Lord. And the expectation and desperation that is within us, Lord. Lord, we just continually want more of you, Lord. Oh God, I pray throughout the evening, as Brother Johnny Cante said, in the hall, in the room, in the car, wherever we are, Father, anything can happen, Father. You can fill us anywhere, anytime, any place, under any condition. Lord, if we have the right attitude, Lord Jesus, if we're desperate, Lord, if we're on speaking terms with you, Lord, if we've dropped every art, oh, Father, anything is possible. Lord, I pray this evening that you bless your servant, Brother Johnny Cante. Lord, may you touch his body, touch him and his precious wife, Sister Sarah. Thank you for bringing him to us, Lord God. Pray, Father, that you, Lord, rest him, Father. And Lord, may you give him back 100-fold of what he ministered here this evening, Father. Bless your people now. Give us traveling mercies. Bless us, our fellowship together as we fellowship around your word, Lord. Lord, may we realize we're walking on holy ground, Lord. Your angels are walking all over this place, Father. So as we exit, Father, may we exit reverently, soberly, Lord, knowing, Father, as we, even as we're walking out, Lord, you can fill us, Lord. Oh, Father, bless us this evening in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 You may find your seat.